Good morning, students. Today we have to discuss question number 35. Let us see. What the question number 35 tells us? This is the solution of 35. Okay. Let us see. A sailor goes 8 km downstream in 40 minutes. Okay. A sailor goes 8 km downstream in 40 minutes and return in 1 hour. Okay. Find the speed of the sailor in the still water and the speed of the current. Okay. Suppose there is a stream. Okay. This one the stream and this stream the direction of the stream is in this direction, okay, and there is a sailor that sailed their boat, okay, this is the sail, okay, this one sailor sailed their boat and the sailor goes 8 km downstream, means downstream means what, where the direction of stream, in which direction the sailor sailed their boat, okay, in the downstream, and downstream in 40 minutes, how much time taken by the sailor, that is 40 minutes in downstream, but if the sailor return from upward direction, that is the opposite to the direction of stream, that takes 1 hour. Okay, let us see here. Suppose this is the direction of stream and the sailor, Now the sailor return back in upward stream. Okay, this one downward stream, this one downstream, this one downstream, and this one upstream. This one upstream. Why? Or this one upstream? Because the direction of stream is in right side, whereas you go opposite to the direction of stream. Okay, this one the direction of stream. This one the direction of stream. So you go along the direction of stream. So this one the downstream. You go opposite to the direction of stream. That means go the upstream. Okay. Then this question asking here that find the speed of the sailor in still water and the speed of the current. Okay. In this question you have to assume that the speed of sailor, the speed of sailor in still water, okay, still water, there is no any current, water current, in this way you have to find in still water, that is x kilometer per hour. You assume let the speed of the sailor in still water is x kilometer per hour and the speed of the current, okay, and you assume the speed of the water current, that is equal to y kilometer per hour. I think it is clear up to which. You know that if the still in still water the speed of the sailor is x kilometer per hour and the y kilometer per hour the speed of the water current. So here in downstream the speed of the sailor becomes x plus y. Here the speed of the sailor you can write here also write speed, that is becomes x plus y because it is in downstream, and here the speed becomes x minus y, not y minus x, because this is the speed of the water current. In water current, this is the direction of water current and you go opposite, so from y minus x you have to subtract from y minus x because y is greater than x, okay, or you go opposite to the direction of upstream, so you subtract the speed of the water current minus your speed, that is the speed in still water, okay, y minus x, okay. So you can write here that speed of sailor in downstream that will becomes equal to x plus y kilometer per hour, okay. And the speed of sailor in upstream that is becomes y minus x kilometer per hour, okay. Again question tells us that it takes 40 minutes go from one point to another point. If sailor goes 8 km, the distance is given here. Here the distance is given, that is 8 km. This is also the 8 km. This one also the 8 km. and takes this one takes how much time given here? How much time given here? 40 minutes. 40 means you have to divide by 60 to becomes hours. 0, 0 cancel out. 2, 2 is 4, 2, 3 is 6. That is equal to 2 upon 3 hours. Okay. You can write here. The time is also given, distance is also given, and you assume the speed of the seller. Okay. So you can write here distance equal to speed into time, or speed equal to distance by time. Okay. You can write here speed of seller in downstream, that is equal to speed equal to distance by time. Okay. Distance upon time, that is distance how much? 8 kilometer, and time taken, that is 2 upon 3 hour. Okay. Time taken, that is 2 upon 3 hours, and the speed of the seller in downstream, that becomes x plus y. If you seller in downstream, x plus y, that will become x plus y. Here you solve this equation, 8 into 3 upon 2, that is becomes 2 4 the 8, that x plus y will becomes 4 through the 12, that is equation number 1. This implied it. This will give us an equation, that is equation number 1. Again, for upstream, if you go the speed of seller in upstream, it will give a value, that is speed equal to distance upon time. Distance upon time, distance how much given here? 8 kilometer divided by time, it takes I think how much? 1 hour. In return back it takes 1 hour, that you have to divide by 1, and the speed, that the speed of the seller in upstream, that becomes y minus x. Okay, y minus x, you can write here y minus x, that is equal to y minus x equal to 8, and this is the equation number 2. As you add the equation number 1 and 2, you get the solution of this equation. Y minus x equal to 8 and plus x plus y. Okay. You arrange it, that is equal to 12, and this will cancel out, the x will be cancelled out, and you will give the value 2y equal to 20, and this will give a value, that is 10, then y equal to 10, you assume the value, the y kilometer per hour, the speed of the water can, that is kilometer per hour. You can write here. Okay. Again, you putting the value of y in 1. Okay. Putting the value of y in 1, if you put the value of y in 1, x plus y, that is 10 equal to 12. X plus 10 equal to 12, you get the value x equal to 12 minus 10, that is x equal to 2 kilometer per hour. This is the value of x, that is you assume the x kilometer per hour, the water current, seller of the speed of the seller in still water, and this is the speed of the water current in y kilometer, that is 10 kilometer per hour. I think this is the solution of the question. Okay, thank you very much.